channel matrix allows individual channel patching. The grid offers on the left and by rows all the available input or sources. They are organized in tabs, one each group of homogeneous sources. In the Andiamo, for example, we have tabs for analog, MADI 1, MADI 2, and the summing buses. In the Xbox MD, we have tabs for MADI SFP, BNC, SC, and Dante. In the M1K2, we have 16 tabs, one each MADI input port. The outputs or destinations are on top of the grid, by columns, and they are organized in homogeneous tabs exactly like the inputs. We can select one tab at a time with a single click, or we can keep Shift depressed and click on other tabs. The grid gets bigger and bigger while we are adding tabs. We can zoom the grid with pinch in and out gestures on a trackpad, or keeping CTRL depressed while rolling the mouse wheel. We can freely navigate the grid with gestures, using the arrow keys, the scroll bars, and the grid buttons, row by row, column by column, or jumping to the beginning or the end with a single click on the relevant button. A single click on an empty cross point makes a patch. A click on a green square unpatches it. As already learned in the port routing tutorial, we can select multiple channels just click and dragging. At the mouse release, we can select patch or unpatch. The color of an output channel is white if nothing is patched to it. It becomes blue when patched. The input channel name is white when it's not routed to any output channel. The input becomes blue if routed to one or more output channels. We can click and hold on the channel name for both inputs and outputs to get more info about the actual routing. This is very useful, especially when the source is not displayed in the current tab. With a right click on the output channel name, we can select Unpatch or automatically display the actual source tab selecting Reveal Source. We can click and hold on an input channel name to show all its current destinations. Both user and system labels are displayed at the same time. We can set a patch tool to quickly repeat the same patch sequence on several outputs. Click and drag selecting the desired number of channels, for example 8. At mouse release, select Set Patch Tool. We can now move the mouse pointer and patch 8 channels at a time with a single click. We can change the direction of the tool by pressing Tab on our keyboard. We can clear the patch tool by pressing Esc on our keyboard, or with a right click and selecting Clear Patch Tool from the pop-up menu. We can quickly copy and paste sequence, even nonlinear ones, and paste it anywhere. Once decided the range of the outputs, select Copy Patch Shape. Only the green cross points of the current tab will be copied. Be careful, they may be not visible depending on the current grid display choice. With a single click, we can now clone the patch on other outputs of the same tab or on other tabs. Powerful, easy, globcon.